And now we will introduce the feature guest of the evening, Mr. George Pops Foster. Evening, George. We're glad to have you with us.
Glad to be here.
George, we've mentioned your name quite a few times on this program, and people all know you. They've known your records. They'd like to hear a little bit about perhaps how you started to play bass and when it was and who you first started to play with. Can you remember back that far?
Well, brother, sister, and myself, we had a little three-piece combination. Played birthday parties. I was playing cello then, them days. I'd stand on a box, reach the cello. And I played cello up until about, from about 19. I just remember the time I started, but I was around 6 or 7 between that playing cello until I was around 10.
Was that all bowing?
Well, I was nothing but straight bowing then. But so far as the picking, I really don't know when I started. I figured I started around 1904, soon I started playing string bass, anyhow. That's when I started. Because I was playing 3 string bass in them days. We used what you call a G, D, and A string. So you didn't have E string then. There was too many strings on string bass them days, for the most old fellas. And then my brother bought a big bass with 4 strings on it, and I had to learn to play the 4 strings. Well, instead of tuning the E strings, as the E string, I tuned it as a C. That's why I can play the 5 string bass today, on account of that accident I'd made then.
Well, what was the first professional band that you played with?
Let me see. We had a little band they called the Roseels. Well, they didn't amount to much. We played quite a few parties, but the first professional band was the Magnolia Band. From the Magnolia, I played around with the Olympia Band, Eagle Band, Silver Leaf Band, Golden Leaf Band.
Well, I guess you must have played with Bunk Johnson and Freddie Keppard.
Oh, I played with them guys many years ago. Bunk when he was a young boy. I was a little fella myself them days. Not old man yet, I don't think.
Well, which band did you play with the longest? Louis Russell?
Louis Russell. I stayed with him 12 years.
Mm-hmm. Then you played with Louis Armstrong for quite some time.
Well, Louis and I played often on together since around 1914. Where we'd go, we'd finally get together around New Orleans, St. Louis. And when he went to Chicago, I went to California. We didn't get back together then until I come to New York, which was 1929.
Well, it was about that time, I think, that you made Mahogany Hall stomp.
That made string bass famous, Mahogany Hall.
Let's hear Mahogany Hall then, shall we?